Now we'll evaluate two logarithms without the use of a calculator when the number part of the logarithm is a fraction. Here we have log base 5 of 1/25th, and here we have log base 2 of 1/16th. To evaluate this, we'll set it equal to a variable, let's say x. Write this as an exponential equation, and then solve for x. To write a log equation as an exponential equation, we need to remember the placement of the base, exponent, and number. B is the base, A is the exponent, and N is the number. A nice way to remember this conversion is to start with the base and then work around the equal sign to form the exponential equation. What I mean by that is we'll start with our base 5. 5 to the power of x must equal 1/25th. So again, 5 to the power of x must equal 1/25. Now we want to write the right side of this equation as 5 raised to a power. Well, we should recognize we can write 25 as 5 squared. So we can write this as 5 to the x equals 1/5 squared. And now using our properties of exponents, if we move this across the fraction bar, or take the reciprocal of this, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So 1/5 squared is equal to 5 to the negative 2. So we'd have 5 to the power of x equals 5 to the power of negative 2. Notice how these are equal, and the bases are the same, therefore x must equal negative 2. Well, if x equals negative 2, then we know log base 5 of 1/25th also equals negative 2. Let's take a look at a second example. We'll set this equal to a variable, let's say y. Write it as an exponential equation. So here the base is 2. So we have 2 raised to the power of y equals 1/16th. So 2 to the power of y equals 1/16th. We want to write the right side of this equation as 2 raised to some power. Let's ignore the fraction for a moment and take a look at 16. 16 is equal to 4 times 4, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So 16 is equal to 2 to the 4th. So we can write this as 2 to the y equals 1/2 to the 4th. And then again, using our properties of exponents, if we move this up to the numerator, or take the reciprocal, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we'd have 2 to the y equals 2 to the negative 4th power. And again, these are equal, the bases are the same. Therefore, y is equal to negative 4. And if y is equal to negative 4, then our logarithm, or log base 2 of 1/16th, is equal to negative 4. I hope this was helpful.